complete nutrition you need without the stuff you don't. So, here's to now.
Boost!
By some estimates, Americans will spend $3 billion on fresh flowers this Mother's Day. Connor Knighton shares a flower alternative some might consider a cup above.
For the past few weeks, this team of florists in Holt, Michigan has been prepping for Mother's Day. Selecting stems, bunching bouquets, boxing orders, and yet, everyone seems surprisingly relaxed.
I'm not stressed about Mother's Day. I think that's the best part about being a paper florist. You can plan for your big holidays way ahead of time.
Even though, hey.
That's right. All of these flowers are artificial.
These are so pretty. I love them.
Liz Carter is the founder of Unwilted, a company that sells paper arrangements with flowers designed by Carter and crafted overseas. She previously worked as a traditional florist.
I definitely thought I was done with flowers, fresh flowers. I was exhausted. And I was looking on social media and I stumbled across crepe paper flowers and just fell in love and I tumbled down the rabbit hole.
There's nothing new about paper flowers. Some of the earliest surviving examples are from 7th century China. In the early 20th century, making flowers was a family affair. Impoverished residents of New York City tenements would enlist their children to help assemble them. There are folding Japanese origami lotus flowers and fluffy Mexican festive bouquets. But social media has led to a sort of super bloom of renewed interest, with people showing off their creations and teaching others how to follow in their footsteps.
You're just gonna pull one side?
These amateur paper pushers are attempting some of Quinn Wynn's floral designs.
Start where the gap is and then just build it across. Look how pretty that is!
I didn't realize I was an artist until I started doing paper flowers, and it just fell into this really beautiful world of meeting other people that love making paper flowers, and it just opened my eye to, like, oh, you can actually do this as a living.
Known online as Pink and Posy, Gwen has managed to craft a career out of paper by taking on everything from corporate commissions
to
co-hosting more than 150 episodes of a Paper Talk podcast.
This one is probably my most difficult flower to make. This is a double peony.
How much trial and error is involved in this?
So much trial and error. I think that's the fun part of this. As of being a creative, as an artist, you're like, what can I do with this flat piece of paper and make something really amazing with it?
While flowers can be made with everything from tissue paper to cardstock, pliable European crepe paper tends to give the most realistic results.
This is the Italian one. This is the 90 gram.
Oh, wow.
And keep stretching it. And keep stretching it.
Working at home in Kirkland, Washington, Wynn takes pains to make her flowers as realistic as possible.
Want to rub it into the paper?
Hand-painting details, obsessing over every petal. Until I touched this, I had no idea that one of these is real and one of these is fake. And honestly, looking at here, I've kind of forgotten which is which.
I'm so happy to hear that. That's the best compliment anyone can give me.
Artist Anne Wood, known on Instagram as Woodlocker, models her hyper-realistic flowers after the ones in her garden. The ones in her hand are made of paper. Paper also offers an opportunity to create fanciful, larger-than-life blooms. Artist Tiffany Turner's giant art pieces show in high-end galleries and sell for tens of thousands of dollars. And yet, there can still be a stigma that paper is cheap or tacky.
I was talking to my mom when I first did paper flowers in Vietnam, and she was like, oh, that was the poor people way of bringing flowers to the wedding because they couldn't afford fresh flowers.
Today, paper flowers can often be more expensive than the genuine article. Which makes sense when you consider all the time involved in making one. The process is the point.
I love the quiet moment of joy when I create something.
Yeah, of course, there's no smell. There's no smell. Although, for people with pollen allergies, that could be a plus. But for bees, it is very confusing. But the biggest selling point for faux flowers is the longevity. As Liz Carter points out, paper persists long after the holidays pass.
Coming from the world of fresh flowers, I was always so disappointed when the flowers would die or wilt. not such beautiful things be so clear.
Which gets complicated.
Hello, Mr. Jennings. Mr. Cooper here.
But also, maybe because as executive producer Steve Molaro sees it, the character of Sheldon Cooper has accomplished his mission, which it turns out is actually a pretty important one.
Some of my favorite moments are when a mom will come up with her son after a panel and say, "My son's a lot like Sheldon, and I know what she means. He's having a tough time, he's different, and thank you for making kids like him more accepted." And the fact that we can even move maybe the needle a little bit on that in the world is a reason to do this whole show.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Field.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomarkin on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye bye.
So anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh no, we have 3, 2, 1.
Bye. Bye.